Diagnosis of childhood TB is often not possible by microbiological methods, and one does need indirect support for infection or disease. One of the methods to identify mycobacterial infection is to do a skin test. It is done by several methods, and one of the commonest methods used and which is going to be taught in this particular clip is called Monto's test, where an intradermal injection with tuberculin is given.
Explain the procedure and take consent from the parent or guardian.
Instruments needed for the procedure are vial of purified protein derivative, that is PPD, with ice pack. This is to maintain temperature between 2 to 8 degrees. Sterile gloves, alcohol pads or spirit, tuberculin syringe, 27 gauge needles, sterile gauze, ballpoint pen, and scale for measuring. The Monto's test is a recommended TST. This is to be given on the volar surface of forearm.
Cleanse the area with alcohol swab. Allow area to dry. TST is administered by injecting 0.1 ml of 2TU RT23 of PPD solution intradermally. If 2TU is not available, no more than 5TU should be used. The PPD should be injected using a 27 gauge needle with a tuberculin syringe with the needle bevel facing upwards. Avoid areas of skin with veins, rashes or excess hair. Inject the antigen into the superficial layers of the skin on the volar surface of the forearm. A 6 to 10 millimeters veal is formed, which is a pale, raised area with distinct edges, having orange peel appearance, and does not disappear immediately. If no veal forms, or if a veal forms that is less than 6 millimeters of diameter, the test should be repeated approximately 2 inches from original site or on the other arm. If minor bleeding occurs, dab the injection site with a cotton swab without applying pressure on the injection site. Avoid covering the area with a bandage. Record the date, time, and site of TST administration. The patient should be advised not to scratch the site. The patient should be asked to return for a reading of the TST between 48 to 72 hours. Induration can be measured by palpatory method. Here, we gently stroke the area around the injection site to identify any raised margins. The identified raised margins are then marked with a pen. The diameter of the indurated area should be measured across the forearm, that is, perpendicular to the long axis. With a millimetric ruler, we measure only induration and not erythema. Induration can also be measured by ballpoint method. In this method, a ballpoint is brought from edge of the arm towards the injection site, exerting moderate pressure against the skin till a resistance is felt due to the raised margin. The point where resistance to pen displacement occurs determines the outer limit of the induration. The width of the reaction is thus identified across the horizontal axis of the forearm. Record results in millimeters of induration rather than as positive or negative. Additionally, report the type and strength of PPD used and the time of reading from the time it was administered.